Welcome back, guys. My levels of frustration with this build are at an all-time high. Let me show you up here. Now, I actually did record putting this in, but stuff happened. Never mind. Up here at Wembley. Now, this is Wembley Park Stadium. This is Wembley Stadium, and this is Wembley Park Station. I should actually put that name in. Okay, so now the way that I've set this up is, remember we just had like a regular station, and we had the outside trains coming through here, and that was causing a problem because there were too many trains, so I disconnected it. Well, now the outside trains can come into this platform, and then we've got the Jubilee line coming into this platform and the Metropolitan coming into this platform. Right, now, but this is pretty big, this station. It's pretty damn big. So I actually had to take out some roads to fit this in. It's freaking huge. It's a lot bigger than I actually thought it was. So we'll just kind of finish this off by just there, hook that up to there, and then hook that across there like that. Okay, cool. Alrighty, now, why aren't I showing you the footage of when I actually put this in? Well, because it all got a bit moany, to be honest. There's the tracks. So, the outside trains coming into this platform, and then you've got, there's the Jubilee line, and there's the Metropolitan line. And as you can see, we've got the tube trains! Which is, I just think that's so cool. I love seeing the tube trains above ground. I think that's very cool. Unfortunately, it does have this, which I guess is what, I don't know, German or whatever, on the top. Other than that, so like, ignore those signs. Other than that, not too bad. So here we go. So we've got the trains coming in. Very nice. Dropping people off. So we're going to have a quick look at the, getting a few people. Yeah, we're getting a few people here. Good stuff. And are we getting trains coming in from outside? That's a good question. Any trains coming in from outside? Not at the moment. We'll maybe have a look at that later and see if we start to get trains coming in. Yeah, so I was getting a bit moany and whatever. Just because this... It's getting so frustrating. And when I was going to show you something. Well, I am going to show you something over in Chelsea. And I was just about to show it to you. And I realized that one of the new mods that I needed to actually show it to you, I hadn't actually turned on. So then I had to quit the game and reload. That's another half an hour gone. And as much as I love the creative element of this game, the whole thing about spending hours looking for mods and assets and every time you want to restart the game, it's half an hour, is just a freaking nightmare. And it is getting me down a bit, I've got to say. So anyway, let's go down to Chelsea and we'll talk about this. Now I've put this little block in here. Let's go and have a look at Chelsea. Let's go and have a look at themes. Now I created this this London high density. Now this is not actually high density; it's actually low density, but they look like high density buildings, which is kind of a bit weird, but it is what it is. Let's go to Theme Manager, and if we look at this and set this to included, you can see I've got these small Georgian terraces, and there are two versions. There's like a regular and a stuccoed. Okay, and there are certain areas of Chelsea and Kensington, and also probably around like Notting Hill, and so let me show for the people who don't know London. There's Notting Hill. Notting Hill, Kensington, and Chelsea. This area is a lot of these kind of Georgian places, but it's interspersed with lots of other different styles. It's a very eclectic mix. London. There's lots of different bits and pieces. So. How would we put these in? Well, the problem with this is that these are only 4x2. right? So they're four long and two deep. So it means you've got to have like exactly that setup, which is not really, it's not really easy. And plus, the guy who's done these has only done a level 5 version, which I find really, really annoying. Now, these ones, this is the same building, just repeated as a level 1, level 2, level 3, level 4. And there's also a level 5. But this guy's only created a level 5. I just find that so, so, so annoying. Like, if you're going to do these, make a level 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 so that people don't have to mess around. I seriously, it's getting frustrating. But so what I've done, I've created this little theme, and I've had to put these in so that I can actually grow this building, because you need to have a level 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a 5 of the same size so you can grow them. But this becomes very, very restrictive, because first of all, I need a plot of land like zoned off, which will be exactly right for these types of buildings. So here I've just put in a little area which creates an 8x4, so I can put four of these buildings in, and I've grown four of these buildings, and I'll show you how I did that. It's kind of basically I zoned this in, and then took out. Oh, come on. And then I took out all of this so that it would just grow one of these 4x2s, right? Then zone the rest in and use the copy to duplicate them so that I've got four of those buildings. Okay, then I realized that I needed the level up mod to force these to level up. So hopefully, yeah, here we go. We've now got a button to force these buildings to level up. But of course it means that I've got to do like potentially every individual building, right? Well, you can do it by district. So I could go to the Chelsea district, right? And force the entire district to level up. Now, Chelsea, let's have a look. Let's see. Whoops. Let's go to districts. So it's only this area, fortunately. So it's not a massive area at the moment. It's not filled in yet, which is why I want to do this, because like, if you look at this, it's kind of this great big gaping hole. I want to fill all of this in so that we start to get nice views of London. And I want to fill it in with the right kinds of properties. Okay, let's try leveling up the entire district and see what happens. This should be fun. Now, I'm guessing that these ones that aren't leveling up are already level... No, see, that's only level 3. Why aren't you leveling up? All of these are leveling up. Now, these buildings that we put in, they have leveled up. Let's see if we can... Oh, see, it's letting me do it. I guess there must be some kind of timer on here so that you can't click it like 10 times in a row. What are we up to? The thing is, once I've got these up to level 5 and we get the buildings that we want, are we going to be able to keep them at that level? Now, that's a very, very good question. Now, do we have, like, level 5 buildings around here already? See, that's level 5. And these are those Victorian terraces, which are popping up. Very nice. Except they're kind of not really in the right places where we want them. But let's keep going and see if we can get this little block sorted out. Because even after we do that, yeah, it's not the end of our problems. Because it means you're restricted to having these like little grids. And of course, London is not like that. I mean, if you look at the street patterns, it's... it's all kind of just like a bit offline. There are little kind of blocks, but it's all a bit higgledy-piggledy. So trying to get this to look like right is incredibly difficult. Okay, so now we've got our Georgia Terrace. Let's look at it from this side so we can actually see what the hell we're looking at. And this is what we want. These are the kind of buildings that you absolutely see, like, all over this part of Chelsea and Kensington. But they are mixed in with other things. That's the thing. So you'll get like a block of these. And let me bring up. So an area like, okay, this bit here, which is kind of the thing I was going for. What you've got here is a park, which is it's a private park. Anybody who's seen the film Notting Hill will know what I'm talking about. This is a private park, and only the people who live around it can use this little private park. And it's like heavily lined with trees. I'm sure I'll be putting up some images so you'll be able to see what the hell I'm talking about. It's heavily lined with trees, and that's what I'm trying to kind of create the feel of. So what we would need to do to mimic that is put in, we want a little park. So how wide do I make this? Let's see. Well, let's just run this road down here a bit. So we'd want, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's make it 4 wide, I guess. Okay, so we'll make the park 4 wide. And then we want the same kind of thing on this side. So, again, we're going to have to put in, this is 4, isn't it? So, this is, oh man. I always make these damn roads too short. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, there, so. So, like that. Okay, so then I've got to unzone this, and we'll turn that into the park. And then this down here, we can zone in the whole thing. Now, having got these, we can now just copy these like this, which at least is a bit quicker. Boom, boom, boom. Oops, didn't want to do that. Alrighty. Come on, grow, do cool things. Right, should we get some, let's do this park. And the trees, like really, they're incredibly dense, the trees around these places. I want to go to this and trees and lots of like oak, elm, those kinds of trees. But this is like seriously. How do I want to do this? Let's take the strength down to about a quarter. And they really are like as dense as this. They're incredibly dense to give the privacy. There we go. Come on, stop lagging. Cool. And then there'll usually be like not much in the middle, to be honest. Let's put another big tree there. There might be, you know, just like a few benches and stuff like that. They don't tend to be particularly formal. It tends to be like a bit of a lawn, some flowers around and stuff like that. But then you've got these really nice houses, and of course the houses overlook the area, the park, so it's all very nice. Okay, so having done that, we then want these along here. Getting a lot of these. Now, these buildings that are popping up, these are not bad. The problem with them is, like, the actual building itself, well, I don't like the steps up, because that's kind of not appropriate. And it's the front yard. The buildings in London tend to be exactly like this, like right onto the pavement. And I really need to get that mod that people keep telling me to get, which eliminates the shadows. Yeah, this is exactly what you would expect. And you get these railings here, and there's usually a little gate at one end, and then steps going down to a basement. Lots of basement flats, which are, so you actually like live in a basement underground. Basically, there's a lot of people in London who are becoming moles. I would imagine there will be an evolution of a mole class of people in the future. Okay, see, I'm losing it now. Right, let's do a bit of zoning then. So, how would we want it? So, we'd want to zone this strip along here like this. And then duplicate this building out up to the end there. Okay, so terrific. We've created this one little block, right, which looks not too bad, right? There are plenty of little areas in Chelsea and Kensington and going up towards Notting Hill that look like this. The problem is, it's so freaking intensive to create these. I think what we're going to have to do is maybe create a few of these little blocks to be kind of representative, and then just let the rest be whatever the hell it is. What are you complaining about? Low land value. Okay, well, that's not good. We'll have to bump that up. This is World's End, this little kink in this road here. This area is called World's End. I'll bring the map up. Does it say? No, it doesn't say. But that, yeah, that's World's End. And there is a road that runs through from here over to here. So let's put that in. The problem is that as soon as you do this, you're going to mess up the zoning. And then we're going to get crappy things that we don't want. It's a problem. It is a problem, guys. And, like, I could put a road down there, but then it doesn't really give us the spacing, because then you've got three deep, and so you've either got a three deep property on one side, or two deep and then one, and that's not going to look good. A lot of problems. Okay, well, I seriously, guys, I'm not really sure what to do about this, but while I'm trying to figure it out, let's at least get some roads put in and stuff. So we've got a big cemetery over here. This is Stamford Bridge, the home of Chelsea Football Club. And then we've got this big cemetery over here, which we will, I guess, put in. I guess it's just now a case of filling that area in. And I'm seriously thinking I'm going to have to change, because I haven't got any high density stuff assigned yet. At the moment, it's all these block houses. If I knock these down, no new ones will grow, because I haven't got any buildings assigned to high density. To a high density theme. Now, like this block here, yeah, you could get away with that block. Although, again, like this parking in front, that's just, you don't get that in London. You just don't. And these buildings are just definitely no. So I think we're going to have to switch to making it like low density and trying to get these terraced houses in, and then I'm going to have to use Rico to just plop some individual buildings to create the difference that we want. Okay, well, that's that. I'll get on with filling these roads in, and we're gonna have to put some stuff in here to create the additional land value. The problem is that I'm pretty sure that having forced these to level up, they're gonna get very, very unhappy, and they're gonna become abandoned because we haven't got the appropriate land value, or well, basically the appropriate levels of happiness. Leisure is already very high, so like, what do I need to do to make these guys happy? So then I've got to go through all of this and try and figure out, like, health. There's a hospital right next to them. Death care. There's a super creme over there, I suppose. Well, we're going to put in the cemetery over here, so I'll put in a super creme along there. Let's see, fire. See, these guys have got fire coverage. We've got a fire station there, so they should be relatively happy about that. Crime? Yeah, crime's low. So what the hell are they unhappy about? I guess it's just the land value. And, like, the land value here is high next to the river. And yet this is, like, really low. So I guess, I don't know, maybe put some, I guess it's just a case of, like, increasing the density. But the problem is, like, a football stadium lowers the land value. Well, no, actually, it kind of doesn't. So I don't know why it does that. It's frustrating game, isn't it? All right, I'm going to stop moaning and get this filled in. Okay, so I filled that area in, and let me tell you, that wasn't as easy as I thought it was going to be. Trying to get the roads to like in some way kind of mimic the real roads, and yet at the same time try and create the right spaces for buildings to spawn. Man, it's really, really difficult. But I've got kind of, like, you can see that I've got, like, the main roads in, like, this one that kind of bends up here, and we've got this, which is the, is that the King's Road going up there? And then we've got, no, this is the King's Road going up here, because the King's Road goes into Sloane Square, which is just there. Now, I was good, just about to do the river, and I thought, you know what, you guys might want to see this, so I think we'll do this bit together. So we've got to put this road that runs along the side of the river itself. So I thought that would be kind of interesting. So let's do that. And I think we're going to put this in with trees. And some of these I've got to go back and change to trees. So for example, where's that bit that we put in? Like this bit around here, yeah, this would definitely have trees along this road. Like, no question. And I can put up there and there and there and along there. I haven't done that little bit. This bit's the cemetery. Should we put the cemetery? Let's put the cemeteries in, because I'm going to put cemeteries plural along here. Oh, can I get another one in? Oh, come on, really? Oh well, it won't let me because of the stadium there. How do we want to do this? Let's move that a bit closer down there, and we'll do the same thing with this one. Move this one in. Now should we like kind of split the meh? I guess we want houses along there anyway, so let's move this down, and then we'll just kind of fill in the area around with trees and stuff. Okay, so that's the West Brompton Cemetery in there. Okay, right, so let's get back to this bit, because I think this might almost be fun. Not a lot of this has been fun so far. Oh man. Let's get freeform. Now this is going to be the problem, getting this, because we want this like really close to this. Ooh. That'll do. And like that. And now, let's have a look and see what this this does. This comes up to this bridge and joins. Now, the problem that we've got is getting these bridges like close to the edge, and it's a bit of a problem because you have to leave a bit of a gap. But of course, when you want to actually join them up, you have to do it like that at an angle, which is not perfect. But kind of not a lot we can do about it, really. And now that road's going to have to go underneath there, so I'm going to have to do a bit of messing around with that as well. Ay, ay, ay. Nothing's ever easy. Nothing's ever easy. So we'll bring that up to there. Oh, and that won't go into there. Let's try doing that the other way around then. So let's take it off there. Oy, oy, oy. Oh, you don't want to come out anything like nice, do you? Oh, man. So we're going to have to do something kind of horrible. Oh, okay. Well, if... Okay, let's do it this way then. Let's do it this way. Let's bring this up here, like, to, like, there. And then we'll do a straight bit, hopefully. Oh, come on. No, right, like that. Oh, come on. Seriously? Why won't you join up? Oh, come on, come on. It went blue. Oh, it'll do it like that. Okay, that'll do. And then freeform. Alrighty. But that, I mean, that's, it's, it does come in a little bit to join that, but it's kind of, that's kind of a bit messy, isn't it? Now let's see, this road comes down here and then it comes around here. So let's start it about, let's see if we can get a bit closer. And try and hug the edge as much as I possibly can. And okay, now we're going to have to do this same kind of stupid thing here. So, to there's about as close as I can get it. And then let's put, oh, I wanted straight, not snap. Oh, come on. Why won't you do this? Oh, there we go. Oh, and it, again, it won't do that. Okay. Do it the other way then. Oh, come on. Oh, there we go. That's the best that we can do. All right, well, it's, I wouldn't call it a pretty junction, but it'll have to do. It'll have to do. Now that comes round here, and then this road goes off over there, which again isn't very pretty. But so we take it off down to about there, and then we'll try and mimic this little grid. I don't know. Let's try and do this a different way. Let's try and put this grid in if we can. Kind of like this. It's so damn difficult though. Well, like that maybe. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But then trying to get these to go like anything like... That's not... See, that's not going to give you four deep there. Okay, let's do this a different way then. This is where you have to make the compromises between what the game will let you do and what the real world wants you to do. So let's put that in like that. Come across, let's see. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So we'd have to come across to there. Oh, come on, go straight. Thank you. So that's at least given us a 2x area. We'll do the same here. So that's 5, yeah. So we're mimicking that little kind of grid. Oh, yeah, yeah. But it's tough. It's very tough. Okay. So we want... Oh, now, we've got Albert Bridge in, but we haven't actually got Battersea Bridge in. Which is kind of weird. Yeah, well, we need to put Battersea Bridge in then. Okay, right. Battersea Bridge coming up. So, let's see. I want it about... And now, this is... This presents its own set of problems, because we're going to have to do the same thing here, because we can't get this to do anything nice across here. Yeah, you know what? I might leave that, because I might end up getting road anarchy, so I can do things like that. And get these bridges a bit closer to the edges. Ah, yeah, yeah. You know what? I'm just wondering whether this will do like anything sensible. I don't think it will. I'm pretty sure it won't. No, because it gets upset. Yeah, I'm going to need road anarchy in order to be able to do that. Okay, well, that's that then. So now we can do this area over here. So we've got, this is the Royal Hospital over here. And there's the hospital buildings up here, and then there's the grounds here. Although I think I was looking at some satellite images of this, and it looks like they're developing something here. I don't know whether they're building a new building. I think maybe they are. So we want to take this up here. So let's take this back. Now this comes into Sloane Square, doesn't it? This goes up here and then up to into Sloane Square. Okay, so let's take that back a little bit. And we'll take this up like that. And then we'll go into Sloane Square there. Alright, cool. So we want this coming across the front. And see, that comes down like a lot further, but I think we'll have to take it across like something like that. Yep. Okay, so we want to put a hospital in there. Now, the Royal Hospital is an old hospital, but trying to find an appropriate hospital building, I mean, probably. That's kind of got the slightly older feel to it. The problem is the size of the damn thing. It's huge. That's a sauna. Definitely not using that. That's too modern. That's too modern. I mean, the Metropole is probably the nicest one. Okay, we'll have to adjust the road a little bit then to fit the Metropole in. So if we bring that up a little bit like that, maybe. Now, I think we should be able to squeeze the Metropole in. Yeah, there we go. So we'll have the Metropole there. And then the rest of this area is the grounds, which obviously, because of the width of the river, is a bit cramped. I may end up, I don't know, I don't think I'm going to play around with the river. I mean, I might end up playing around with the river, but I don't think so. I think we're just going to live with the river the way it is. The problem, several people have left comments recently, and I guess it's people who are relatively new to the series, saying, oh, the river's too wide, you need to make it, you know, like thinner. The problem is, if I do that, it's just going to look terrible. I mean, you can only just about get a bridge like this across here. And we need bridges with like two spans so that they look right. And like proportions wise, the river needs to be like a decent width. Otherwise, it's just gonna not gonna look right. So anyway, what was I was doing? Oh yeah, I was doing this. I'm gonna plop some trees in around this. So there's also an area over here, but we'll fill this area in here as much as we can. Let's make this a little bit stronger. There we go. That'll have to do. That will have to do for the Royal Hospital. Okay, right. So let's just finish off the roads in this area and then we can zone it in and grow it. Wouldn't that be nice? So what do we want to do? We want a road that comes up here. Oh man, trying to get roads to go like the right angle that you want. Again, like nothing's easy. Everything you try and do is like a challenge that you have to overcome. Right, can come down there like that. We want another one coming down. Let's turn the snap off. We want this really coming down, kind of like that. Aye, aye, aye. And then these go like diagonally across there, so that will represent that. And then the same here. Now, I would like these to be sort of four wide, but you just can't do it. So, the same here. Oh, that's kind of almost. I'm kind of tempted to move these two just so that they're a little bit wider. Let's extend this road out here. Again, now I want to put snap on. Let's just extend that out a little bit. So I want this road to come down like that. Then we can trim that back and we can send it out this way. Okay, and I guess we're going to join it up with that. Yeah. Alrighty. And over here, that's Victoria Station. Even though it doesn't say it's Victoria Station. Yeah, oh, there it is. Yeah, there you go. Victoria Station. Aye, aye, aye. So we've got, I've got to do that road under there. Let's finish off filling this area in. So this is the Sloane Square area. It's a posh area, Sloane Square. So we want a road down there. Road. And again, I'm trying to get the spacing for, but look, see, it doesn't do it. That's a freaking nightmare. And unless you're actually doing a grid, trying to get the spacing and stuff right, so hard. That is, yeah, that will give us two and two. Okay, and then. Now, this is really posh. Belgravia. This is a very posh area. This is some of the most expensive real estate in the world. Now, I think we'll... I've got to find out what that is. There's obviously a church there, but I don't know which church it is. I'm going to use these roads for now, and then I'll put some nicer ones in later. Again, I think I need to go one further in order to get the spacing right. Now, that road is going to have to go around and then over the train tracks. God, that isn't going to be easy. Is there any chance that we could get that, like, over? I don't think so, but we'll try. What if I turn no pillars on? And, no collisions. Oh, got it. Oh, my God. Unbelievable. How far out am I going to have to go? That is the best we can do. Really ugly when you do bridges like that, isn't it? It's a shame, but that's the limitations that we've got. So stop complaining about it. Live with it. Right, so change it back to default. And now let's see. So yeah, that comes down there. There's another road that comes across here. That. I have no idea what this is. I'm going to have a look at that. What the hell is that? I have no idea. Okay. All right. I'll figure it out. Right. We just got this little bit of Belgravia to do. And then we're done. So, man. Out from there. Doesn't give me really the spacing that I want. So, again, I think I'm going to have to... this is why I want to show you this stuff, because I want you guys to see just how difficult it is when you're not doing a grid. So that's going to be like that. And this road's going to come up here. Now, are we going to get... Yeah, we should get some decent zoning doing that like that. And then, again, the spacing isn't particularly great. If I take that road out, because it's bent at the moment, it's in two sections, put it in a single section, then I might be able to... there we go. Let's do it down to there, I guess. All right, cool. And then we've got Victoria Station there. Okay, so let's have a look. So yeah, we've done that. Cool. Now this little bit over here. We've got some kind of park going on there. You know, I'm going to look at that, and I'm going to have a look on the satellite before I mess around with that, and see. And I've got to figure out this area as well. But let's get this zoned. And let's let it grow. Right, should we grow it? Let's grow it. Let's turn you on, speed you up. And watch Chelsea, hopefully, come to life a bit. Oh, it's one of the best bits, isn't it? Watching all of this come to life. So instead of this, like, all bare, nasty, empty stuff... all going to fill in now. But we do have this issue with land value. Now, hopefully increasing the density of the buildings will help to increase the land value. But I think we're going to have to give it some extra help to increase the land value. And we need to do it fairly quickly before this stuff starts going abandoned. This bit down here is really bugging me. Let's bring the map up. So we've got a college and a school down here. I think we're going to end up putting it there. So we'll have the high school there. And are we going to have an elementary school as well? All right. So we need to zone that bit in now, don't we? Yes, we do. And, yeah, I've got the big brush. Oh, it's a bit slow. Oh, it's saving, that's why. Let's fill all that in. But you do get like these bits on corners that don't fill in nicely. I guess we'll put some trees or something there to fill that in. Alright. Drop the map down. Alrighty, so we're getting there, but what we're gonna have to do now is level up the area so that we start getting the nicer buildings that we want to see. Ho ho ho, look at that go. Cha-ching. That's real growth, isn't it? Let's force level everything. That's a good mod. Another Bloody Penguin mod, that is. Force level up, it's called. So there you go. If you've got any tips on increasing the land value, then please let me know. There's only that one complaining now, though. I guess probably because the others have got abandoned that were complaining. Yeah, see, look at this. This was our nice little area, and it's all got screwed up. So yeah, gonna have to do some work on that for sure. All right, guys, we will leave it there, I think. Should I do one more level up? Yeah, go on, let's have one more level up. Cha-ching. What are you up to now? That's commercial. Okay, so that's coming up to max now. What are you coming up? Yeah, that's coming up to max as well. Oh, yeah, so now we're seeing a lot of these Georgian Terrace buildings popping up. The problem is that they do tend to be quite regular. You get like a block of these. You don't get them scattered around like this. So I'm probably going to have to mess around with the eyedropper tool. But, I mean, I know that I'm going to have to do that a lot anyway. So it is what it is. All right, guys. We'll end this with a bit of a hopefully nice look at the new Chelsea. We've got to extend this up into Kensington, making it look the same. But this looks a hell of a lot better than these horrible, nasty, ugly buildings. So, yeah, a lot of this needs to go on. And I've still got to sort out what I'm going to do with the offices. All right, guys, we'll leave it there. I'll catch you for the next one. I hope you enjoyed it. Peace out.